a little review about the Mark 1 Škoda Fabia for anyone interested in buying one. I've owned this car for about 4 months now, and it's one of the best cars I've ever owned. I used to have a Škoda before, and this is far, far superior. It's really good on fuel. It's a little 1.23 cylinder. I roughly get between 37 to 40 miles to the gallon just going to work and back. It's really torquey on hills. Nice and spacious, really comfortable seats. You've got your instrumentation, basically what you need. You've got your speedo, rev camera, fuel gauge, temperature gauge. Obviously all your warning lights that you need are in the middle. As of warning lights, heated rear window, all your heating and ventilation controls down there. Manual window winders, electric front windows, central locking. It's 2004. Paid £870 for it with, well, I put it, I think, about 111,000 miles on the clock. So I've only put a few thousand on it so far. Things to watch out for. They are common to have leaks in the footwells. Now, this is due to the rubbers on the door cards fading sometimes. It's quite an easy fix. It's just a case of putting some sealant around the bottom of the window regulator, and that kind of cures it then. Parts are really cheap to acquire from your main dealer. It's just overall just a really good car. Check out parkers.co.uk for reviews on the Škoda Fabia, owner's reviews, what it costs to run. Really cheap on petrol, really cheap on insurance. Right, I'm going to take you for a little drive on the dual carriageway. These are really quiet on the motorway at 70 miles an hour. Usually sits at about 3,200 RPM. My 1.2 Corsa I used to own was about 4,000. You could hear it. This thing here is whisper quiet, so it's ideal for motorway journeys, especially with the seats being so comfortable as well. So here we go. As you can see, the acceleration for a little 1.2 is quite nippy. Have it. That's about it, really. Thank you very much.